the chest. Man. Gonna be playing Visage. Play this game for a while. Glad that I finally picked it up. Supposedly supposed to be one of the looking cool with me. I like spooky games. I'm a huge fan of the Silent Hill series. Played the Resident Evil series. I played Siren. If you haven't played Siren, I recommend Siren. A difficult game to play, but it's still really fun. If you're, I played many horror games. Dying Light, Killing Floor 2. I even play the Friday the 13th game every now and again. Dead by Daylight. I do play the Resident Evil franchise, which it's not as scary as it used to be, which is fine, whatever. I'm not too big of a diehard, like, it's not to say they nerfed it. I'm just enjoying the whole, how the story is progressing, the whole lore behind the, you know, Resident Evil. So, I don't really have too high hopes for most games, right? I'm not saying that it's gonna suck or anything, this game. I'm just not that guy. I'm never like overhyping a game, except for when it came to the Final Fantasy VII remake. Then I did overhype quite a bit, because I was just like, that was my thing, you know, like, I loved Final Fantasy. I was a huge fan. Still am. So, I mean, that game was overhyped for me. I couldn't wait to see the new graphics, how they're going to do everything, see where they're going to go with the story, you know, what and what have you. So, let's get into this game. Visage is hard. Patience, thorough investigation, and good resource management are your best friends. Good luck. This right here looks like Silent Hill 4, The Room. Big time. That's what this reminds me of. Just like Steven Crowder, you know, that whole prove me wrong thing he does. That's what this reminds me of, you know. Prove me wrong that does not look like Silent Hill 4, The Room. Which was actually supposed to be called a different game. It's supposed to be an entirely different game. Konami's like, you know what? Let's just make this the next Silent Hill game. And it was actually really, really freaky. You know, some people will agree with me, others won't. I don't care. I thought it was creepy. Man, what's going on? Am I supposed to be doing this, or? Oh, no. Okay, it's a cutscene. Sweet.
No cam today?
No, not today. I just didn't feel like setting up the cam. And I didn't feel like getting myself all done up. You know, I had to shave and do my hair. I didn't feel like doing it. I'm homesick today from work. I had a high fever. I actually have to go get COVID testing done because I had a fever. So just trying to make sure that I don't have COVID.
Thanks to this speech thing, now you owe me attention to chat, lol.
Yep. Dude, this is like some... You ever see that movie Sinister? This reminds me of right here. Oh. Dude, this... Oh my goodness, dude. This is sick.
Oh damn, that sucks, bro. Hopefully you recover quick.
Oh, dude, that was like, woo! No, yeah, I'm sure I'll be alright. Like, I only got like a slight cough, and you know, it kind of feels like I'm getting like a cold or a flu.
You look good, by the way, looking thin.
Oh, thanks, man. I've been working hard. Okay, so this kind of
reminds... game is nutty.
Yeah, dude, I'm actually really scared to play right now. Like, progress room. Okay. Okay, so I wonder what the...
I saw my boy playing this the other day.
Yeah? Was it good?
It shows.
Dude, this, in my headset, it's got it's a surround sound 7.1, right? So it sounds like somebody's walking behind me.
Hello, Twain. It's Rose, your neighbor.
What's up, Rose?
I know it's late, and I know that I tend to be a little anxious about small things.
Yeah, my boy can only play for so long cause he can't handle it for long.
I haven't seen you out of the house in about 3 weeks. Is everything all right? Could you call me just to let me know everything's fine? All right. Bye-bye.
Freaks him out too much and stresses him out, lol.
Yeah, I can see that. Like, this game definitely has that feel to it. But, you know, me growing up the way I did with all the paranormal experiences that I've experienced, I may not be as, you know, stressed out about it. But we'll see, though. I mean, I'm not, you know, immune to being scared. Ugly-ass couch. Okay. Can I throw this? Well, there's like fingerprints all over everything too. Like the detail on this thing is crazy.
Oh yeah, this is Upire Alley. For sure.
Oh my goodness. You need to take better care of your house, bro. Like fucking, you got Kyle staying here, bro. Other than my Monster Energy drinks, put holes in your shit.
But this game is also challenging and spooky.
Yeah. That's what I've been hearing, man. Cause like, I'm not that good at puzzle games. I used to be really good, but you know, hopefully I shine here, you know? Huh, okay. So character Sandy plays a part in the game, which is freaky. Shut the lights out, see? Did it do anything? Yeah. I'm gonna cut all these lights out. We gonna have us a seance up in here. Where your life was at. There they are. Okay, that's crouch button. Spirits of this house, tell me, what was we talking about? Alright, now it's dark in there. I'm gonna mess with this dude's mind a little bit, or check, or whatever it is. Go down here where everybody knows who it is. Whoa, dude. Yeah, I'm freaking out a little bit now. How you gonna cut the light back on, man? Alright. What?
In the great city of Riversdale. Today, the weather is going to be absolutely celestial. The temperature won't drop below 77 degrees, and it's going to be one hell of a sunny day. Get your sunscreen towels out and take your whole family to the beach. Take a day off and show your loved ones how much you care about them on this wonderful vacation. On another note, today we got a special...
Can you replace this thing, or...? Yeah, I did it. Yeah, novice electrician. You're like maintenance man, not electrician now. You gonna change air filters and shit in here? Get into the sink? It kinda reminds me of PT though. Like with the radio and everything and how it's kinda laid out. I don't know if you played PT. Like that Silent Hill demo. Bro, like, everybody I know has a photo just like this. I was just looking through my mom's photos not too long ago, and my uncle is in this exact same pose with, like, one of my siblings. I will keep that on. But... basement key. Is this the basement key? Yeah, let's pick it up. Let's go upstairs. These lights on. All right, so a buddy of mine, actually my co-host on Grim Radio, he just moved out of his place yesterday, and I was helping him, you know, this past weekend. He was telling me that he went back for his bed Saturday night, roughly around midnight. And about 1 o'clock in the morning, he was like getting his bed down out of his the master bedroom, and he noticed something out of the corner of his eye, so he just stopped and watched whatever it was, you know, happen. And he said that he saw like a short statured individual, almost like a leprechaun, he said, like tilt its head at him, but it was like looking at him, and he just kind of like shrugged it off, like, ah, it's whatever, you know. So he, you know, gets the bed downstairs. He's in his kitchen. What was he doing? He was like cleaning out his like Yeti cup so he could get more water. And he saw this dude walk into the kitchen and look into a box that was on the other side of the kitchen table and just kind of looked up at him and was like, what's up? And he turned and looked and saw a dude, like, straight up, just saw this fucking dude standing there. And he starts, like, you know, telling it to get away from him. Like, he like, squared up with it, man. And motherfucker, like, he blinked his eyes and dude was gone. I guess that was, like, his first, like, actual, like, for reals paranormal experience that he's ever had. Not quite a bit. He said he's had them before, but he just kind of brushed them off and ignored them. But this one, actually, he was like, I believe it goes exist now. But before, he was kind of like, eh, whatever, you know, random shit falling over and stuff. He was just like, ah, that could be explained away or whatever. Sometimes it can be, but we were all in a room one time, and a bottle of lotion came flying off of our friend's dresser, like, at us. It didn't hit any of us, but it came, like, flying off of that fucking dresser. Freaked everybody out. Sorry, I got the burps. Oh, that's how that works. Okay. You have to push the button, or hold the button, and then close it. I get it now. It's like playing with Barbie Dreamhouse. Paper towels from Costco. It's crazy, you can hear so much going on in the background. Pasta dental? Pasta. That sounds right. Okay. Do that. Have to knock off shoes right here. Huh. You can hear like air or something coming from right here. Like the AC. I'm standing in the dark. Okay. cut the light out in here. Wasn't me. Shut the door. Maybe the ghost won't come out. All right, so another creepy fact here is I currently live in a house that's haunted. Doesn't nothing like this though, like shit like that. I have heard something like that around here though before. I thought it was one of my children and they were all asleep. Get it open. You're a vampire. You got no reflection. Oh, cool. Stuff in here, huh? Or everywhere. I don't know why I'm still holding this pill or this pill bottle. There's another one right there. Yay! Oh, this might get stuff in it, huh? Just shut up. Oh, okay. I don't know if I want to go in there. But I will. Yeah, let's go. Knew that was going to happen. Okay, so you share a closet with the kids? Or is that just how you get into the nursery? Okay, so it is raining outside. Oh, isn't that cute? Got a bear, elephant, Penguin? I like Totos. So confused on what to do. Other than examine it. Like, touch everything because it's pissing off these spirits. Mr. Cat. Doesn't look very friendly. Alright. Came upstairs. Another one. Cool. This is neat. This is neat, but it's kind of dark in here. See the whole world from here. Those do. Papers. Kick some ghost ass. I don't know how to do that, but pretty sure eventually I'm gonna have to. Yay! Oh, it's that creepy room. Some people got shot. What? Dude, that's awesome. Where'd it go? Oh, okay. Right. Oh, that's awesome.
Oh, what? All right, so it's upstairs now. Let's go.
Where's that jam? All right, let's get these lights on. So he's not so scared. Turn every light on in his house. If you're in a haunted house and you're scared, best thing to do is make sure you have all the lights on. It helps you be brave. You can't read the cassette. You don't need to read it. Play it. Hey, I found a key. Or that. All right, let me solve this shit real quick. Oh, in the basement. Hey, where'd this come from? That's kind of unsettling, though, to see normal on one side and this blacked out thing on the other. How about now? I'm gonna have to come back with a damn ladder. What about? No. See if there's a step stool or something in here. Yummy! Go make some hot cocoa. Hot chocolate. Dude, I'm just trying to get something to drink. Keep fucking with these lights. That was a light switch anyway. There we go. Oh, craft beer. Look at that. that shit. Flops. Oh, okay. Lots of beer in here. I wonder if I can use this cocoa on there. No? Yes. Let's put some match up. Hot cocoa, whatever this is. Is there any milk in here? Down there. Found some yummy milk. Alright. Now we're getting somewhere. Shazam. Look at me doing things. Ha! Dope cow milk. So fun little fact, 3:33, right? So 3 o'clock in the morning is the witching hour, supposedly. Alright, because supposedly in, you know, witchcraft and stuff, supposedly Jesus was crucified. Where'd he go? Was crucified at like 3 o'clock p.m., right? So with, you know, witches and stuff like that, they practice their witchcraft stuff at 3 o'clock in the morning. That's when they get the most power. You know, it's like that as above, so below saying. Hey, look, I found another one. Huh, wonder why that other one didn't disappear that I found. Maybe I had to interact with things first, like do something and then it disappears? Basement key, really? It's another part of the damn basement. Okay, candles are stationary lights. You can be lit with a lighter, moving around with a candle. That's a level. and put stuff up on the wall, level it, or check to make sure that it's level, not crooked. That's what that's for. For those of you that didn't know. This is some spooky dark right here. Pick this up. Why is it even on? That's a weird thing. This is leaves. Plastic on everything. It's a huge basement. I live in Arizona, so basement's kind of like are intriguing to me because we don't really have them here. It's more of like an East Coast thing. Come on, man, pick it up. Okay, so it's empty. Alright, so the reason why I'm closing everything, if this is like a paranormal game, that's how I know if something paranormal happens. So, for instance, I was helping my friend move, and I know I closed his office door before I walked outside. And this is about 6 o'clock, and about 6 o'clock it's starting to get dark, right? As the weather's starting to cool down. Now, when I came back inside, it is way too fucking dark in there. When I came back inside, his office door was like wide open. So I asked him, I was like, dude, I'm pretty sure you closed that, right? Or I closed that. Why is it open? He was like, are you sure? And I'm like, yeah, dude, I'm positive I closed it. Another thing, too, was he had a fan that was upstairs. I set it in the bathroom. He didn't go up after, you know, I came back downstairs. And the fan was in this other room. In the other room, oh, hell. The other room is like his spare room where he kept his mats so he could do he does jiu-jitsu. So that's where his jiu-jitsu mats were at. Okay, so it's been a circle. Dude, I can't see shit. Okay. Anywho. So, yeah, his jiu-jitsu mats were in there. But I was always, like, sketchy about the room, you know? It always had, like, a weird-ass vibe to it. And he got the same thing. Like, he didn't like being in there. He just kind of shrugged it off, like, oh, whatever. You know, as long as he lived there. I think he lived there, like... But he had been telling me about other things that happened there. And he just kind of, like I said, just shrugged it off. Okay, I didn't see that this time. First time. Weird symbol on it. Okay. At least I know it was a locked door or something there. So, looks like I'm gonna need a lighter, I guess. See? Stuff like this. I've experienced stuff like this. Door's closing on me. Why not? I'm gonna leave that one open to see if he does it again. Well, we better be able to play this VHS. It's in this freaking player right here. Alright. Oh, it can read video cassettes. Okay. I gotcha. Turn these lights back on. I found a note. Looking for the garage key? It's probably in your jeans pocket in the laundry room, as always. Thank me later, honey. Couldn't even tell there was a damn door right there. That's because I cut out all the damn lights. Genius. Like stupid dark in there. Alright, so if you ever seen the movie Annabelle, I think it's Annabelle Creation. The one where all the like little orphan girls go to that house. So in that movie, there's a scene where the little girl's like throwing the ball or whatever out into the hall, like shooting it out in the hall and then like reeling it back. So in that scene, it's like stupid dark. You just kind of like, I don't understand that. Like, why is it so dark in there? That same darkness I've seen like growing up and whatnot. So it's... That movie did freak me out because there was a lot going on in it that I had experienced growing up. Such as the darkness, like some of the jump scares I've actually witnessed like when I was really, really young. I thought I was dreaming, but some of my other siblings could verify, you know, my experience. Of like clothes and stuff moving and like floating out of the hall, out of the closets, not out of the hall. You know, hearing things running up and down the hallway when everyone was like in bed. I've heard animals. I've actually heard animals and stuff. Probably. I want to say about 10 years ago, and I placed it up. No, not even that. It was like five years ago in a place that I lived. And I also heard like bare feet of someone running down the hall, but my wife actually saw like a little girl or something go into our bathroom. So are these the ones that I found? And they just come, like, appearing on the shelf? Okay, that's cool. So there's these dolls. Okay. So my assumption is that I'm looking for a stepladder or something. Something, or a tool or something to reach up there. See how dark that is right there? That threshold where there's a light on and you should be able to see inside of there with that light. That's some creepy shit I've seen before. This ain't no joke. It's not the best to go walking around in. What is this? Okay. Yay, dynamic items. It means this will respawn in the storage room located in the basement when left behind. Okay. That's cool. Now, is there anything in here that I can use? Right about now. The answer is no. Basement rules. Put the toys back in their place. No yelling. Turn off the TV. When leaving the basement, ask Dad for the key if you need something in the storage room. Ugh, don't try to go in the locked rooms. Have fun. This house is huge. The layout's very weird. I mean, but if I ever found a house that was for sale like this, I'd probably buy it. And if it is haunted, I'll probably get it on the cheap. So, just exercise them demons real quick. Get them ghosts up out of there. Mm-hmm. I wonder what the significance is of, like, examining everything. Like, there's probably, like, an achievement or a trophy or something for doing it, but other than that, I wonder what the importances. Yay, more static. Alright. Find a vinyl record somewhere. Clearly. Let's put the camera here. Yeah, that's what I was. Okay, water heater. Not really a good sound for a water heater to be making. What's this? Yes! There it is! I found the lighter! Pick up the lighter and them drugs, and we in business. Electric room. You got a whole electric room? Alright, let's see. Nope. Down in the basement. That's right. There's the light switch. More advanced darkness. Ooh, chainsaw. Some paint, yeah. Get that chainsaw. Get them ghosts up. What is this, Creepshow? I can't really read that. Oh my God, Jesus Christ. Whoa, 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 easy now. It's okay, it's okay. I'm sorry, we didn't mean to scare you. I'm 52 years old. 52! You're lucky you didn't give me a heart attack. We've already seen enough broken hearts for one night, which is exactly why we're here. The area is under investigation. We ask that you stay in your house until further notice. What happened to Lucy or her parents, we're not at liberty to discuss. Yes, it's very confidential. Now, ma'am, I'm telling you one last time. Stay inside until further notice. I flip it over. Ha 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 ha. Okay. so what the hell. That was cool, I guess. Kind of creepy. Oh, excuse me. No, that is the same cord. So, if I was going to find anything to help me. Toilet in there. Ugh. Alright, so if I was gonna find anything to help me find or get reach the attic, it would be down here, I would assume. Like that, Brennan, maybe? Maybe not. So I get quiet when I get to thinking. It's like, except for when I'm taking a test, for whatever reason, I get very, very noisy. I just don't understand it. Okay. Sorry, I was reading the text. From a friend. So I got friends sometimes. Or at least they call me their friend. Alright, so there's this odd place here. So yeah, they weren't lying about that patient stuff, man. Like, I really gotta be patient. This, I can't stand this stuff. I come in contact with it daily, actually. But it's a good thing that it only it's just on my hands. Sometimes it gets on my arms. Oh my goodness, it's dark. It's dark down here. I'll turn the light on for you. Wherever it's at. Wonder. Huh? So I wonder if the candles, they actually burn down. Oh, that's cute. I'm over here thinking, like, simple, like, okay, just grab one of these chairs, take it upstairs, and fucking stand on it, and open up the attic. No. I want to interact with this. No. I want to go outside. Whoa, cool. In the rain. It may sound crazy, but I want to go outside. In the rain. Cause I think I'm gonna cry. Hey, one thing this game is doing is make my head hurt. Constantly like, okay, what am I doing? Tails. More tails. Alright, so the key for the garage should be in here. Uh-oh. There it is. Oh, so was this the spot that the mirror was showing us? And this way. Damn TV keep coming on. It's broken. Karusha. Oh man, I'm telling you, this pic reminds me of that movie Sinister. Alright, I just want to say something real quick. I was looking at this, and I don't remember even, like, touching my controller, so I think my controller might be malfunctioning a little bit on me. Yeah. Is that making you better, buddy? Not staying in the dark anymore. Guess not. Whoa, dual lighters. Who wants to mess with me now? I got two. I got double the light. Bring it, ghost. I said turn that shit on. Hmm. The light switch is down here. Is that for the light that's up there? Yes. What the hell is up with this light? You trick. Oops. Okay, we picked that up. Pretty little sensitive ass. Fall out. Dude, see, this is that. I need something like that. To get that fucking thing open. Come on, let's go. Let's go with it. Of course. Don't want to make it too easy, right? There we go, and I can go be on a scary ass. Beep beep. Say, what the hell just happened? There we go. Now I'm locked every single door. I don't really see anything in here though. Clipboard. Hey, see, I need something like this. Grab that ladder. Let's go. Dude, why are you getting so anxious? Health director retired from business after 45 years. Yes, I can read upside down. I know apparently that's some crazy skill that some people have and others don't. I don't believe it just because I can do it. Did I find? All right, so I'm finding different things. That's good, I guess. Now I have to go find another key. And what is illuminating this space here? I'm missing something? Okay, so... that's weird. This room is closed, huh? Hmm. I'm supposed to bring more candles or something? Go get some Kool-Aid. Can't burn books, really. Why are we just a lighter? It would take a long time. Tore out the pages. Welcome back here. There it is. Like, I thought I saw a watery poster. You fill it. Fill it up. Get it in there, Holmes. Get some water. It's not... whatever. More beer. Push the buttons. Come on, man. I just got a new mug. Oh, cool. There's another lighter. Somebody tell me where to go. I'm so confused. See, I know I checked most of these places. Ugly ass couch here. I need a VHS. I need a vinyl record. I need to find like a small key. Back upstairs. Yeah, might have some luck up there. Got me all up in here. Okay, cool. Oh, there's a light switch on, huh? So, is there a lighting fixture? Yep. Tiny bastard. Oh, cool. That's the Terminator. Don't even front. Oh, hey. Some more. Is that a comic book? The Neighbors. Page missing. Spaghetti circles, you know that's damn. SpaghettiOs.
Okay.
But even still, like, I found pages that they weren't missing from that particular book, but they were missing. If I could grab a light bulb, put it in the ceiling fan, but still though, how am I supposed to get to that? I got to smash the can. Okay, let's go down, give me a light bulb. So my kids do have a I don't want to say it's a doll, but it's like this dancing doll kind of thing, and it does it's running the batteries, so it makes it Oh nah, kinda easy. Oh well, kinda easy though. My patience is running down. Rocking chairs right up above me. Okay. That's the significance of yeah. handle is out of reach. Where the F can I find something? Hit the button there, gambling. What the? Oh wow, I didn't even freaking notice that. I ran right into him. Hold up. Game starting to get a little bit interesting. So it was this way. So this way. All right, so I found this poker thing, right? To get us up into the attic. So what I'm gonna do, okay? I'm gonna go up to that attic and try not to be scared. I mean, I'm not really scared. Like, this game's, because it's making me think so much, I'm not as afraid, you know, like I'm into the game, but the fact that I'm trying to figure this thing out, it's not really doing it for me, you know. It's actually kind of taking me out of the scary ambience of the game. That's me though, that's just my logical brain when I rationalize everything. Maybe I can't use this here. There we go. Somebody have a let me out. Oh, that's cool. Thank you. see what's going on with this chair over here then. Man, I spent all that time getting up here, just have to go right back down. What the fuck is that, though? Got some scary stories to tell in the dark stuff. Sun and tea are written on the box. It's a lot, okay? Some scary stories to tell in the dark stuff right there. Where? Am I in the same house? A little bit weirded out now, but not. More on like a what the hell's going on type thing. Yeah. So it's a bunch of numbers. 50373. Or is it 50573? I can't tell. 50573. They did a pretty decent job on like the detail of the game. That bad boy and that player.
Dolores' symptoms are aggravating. Doctors tell me it's become very hard to pinpoint the exact disorder. They tell me she's got symptoms of schizophrenia, bipolar disorder, psychosis, dementia, and more. Worse. Today she told me she often hears her own voice whispering a sequence of five numbers through the baby monitor. She said it's the key to her inner house.
Hmm.
What does that even mean? What am I supposed to do?
What numbers are they, bro? You can kind of see the lighter. That's locked. So bad. Your inner house. So I'm guessing the inner house is this room. But even still, how the hell do I get on up out of here? Hey, is it 503 7 3. Okay, so I can't open that. I don't have a key for it. Unless I bash his damn brains out. So these things here. There's nothing under the bed. Or at least it won't let me interact with anything under the bed. Okay, so I turn the switch on. So that's what everything is here. Something is missing, well, like this tree right here. Alright, so it sounds like something over here. Something happened over here. Oh, that's what happened. And then, oh, that's gone. Oh, hey, there we go. Oh, cool. I just say I'm about to go mad, man. What the hell happened? Okay, now the game's getting a little bit more interesting. So it seems like more than one thing happening here, huh? And it's going like way, way back. Ooh, is that like intestines or something? Might as well, right? You're locked in your house. I see it. Some type of like intestine looking thing. You're going in a dark hole. You might as well go down in it. Whoa. How do I get out of here, dude? Now this is getting into some really creepy shit. So where is the sucker at? Maybe I was supposed to turn around. Ooh-hoo. Beat his ass, damn it. The insanity level on this dude's not going crazy. I'm staying in complete darkness. Hmm. wonder what the trick is to this. That got really loud, really quick. I was not expecting that. It was so quiet, and then BAM! I jumped a little bit. It was a good jump scare. I wasn't expecting it. My child. Okay. Nah, this game's getting a little spooky. Now all I gotta do is go find a child. Find a child. Sledgehammer. Whoa, okay. Thank you. Oh.
That was cool.
Yeah, I've experienced things like that before. Like, it's not like something's running at you. No, can't break nothing. Oh, let's say, oh. Can't get it out. Oh! What the F, dude? Yeah. I don't know if I like that. That is creepy. In a very, very gross way. Alright, so there's mirrors and junk laying around. I gotta go around breaking them. Oh wait, never mind. That's what that broad was asking for. Loose change. Shit, yeah it is. My actual insanity is decreasing kind of fast. Nah, I'm just kidding. I'm good. Let's go ahead and play this. Okay. Got some vertigo, I would not recommend watching this. Peace. I can't help but be silent right now, man. I'm just kind of like, I'm really in awe right now of what's going on. Down the basement. But I'm trying not to be all willy-nilly about, like, where I'm going. I'm trying to think it through. Read backside. Kids, if you need something in the electric room, go ask Dad in his office upstairs. Sweet. Alright, let's go upstairs. Oh wow. This is the trippy part, because there's... Now there's this plate, this space, there's that space over there, there's another hole, it's like... I'm just gonna try and go upstairs, if I can, to get this damn key. Oh, I can't. So I'm gonna have to find the appropriate. Nope, never mind. Oh my goodness. Okay, so I am gonna have to pick one of the different holes to go through. Maybe I'll just go through this one. Maybe. Well, that answers that for me. However, do I want to go through the dookie hole or that ladder? Let's go to the dookie hole. Probably should have went up the ladder. Oh, okay. At least it brought me to this broad.
Bring me my child.
Is this your child? No, guess not. There should be something in, I have the thing in the. Oh, no, there's a vice or whatever. Thing right here. Yeah. And crank it until it explodes. Found a note with strange scribbles on it. Let's read it. Okay. So we got like 3:30, 6 o'clock, 12:30. That's weird. That's cool at the same time. Alright, let's go. See if we can talk to Dad. Wait a second, where was Dad's teddy at? Was it right here? Or was it down the hall? Over here. Yeah. Yeah, right here. Right here. If I was a key, where would I be? Probably in this thing. There it is. What's up, Dad? Fusion bag? What the? Oh, wow. I have to go find a knife, put it in him, and his hand's gonna open up. And then that's where I'm gonna get the key. Alright, go find this damn knife then. Apparently I gotta impale Dad. I gotta go find a freaking light bulb. So many doors like that, though. Are you open your hand right now? Open it. No. Alright, let's go to the kitchen. And see. Oh, heck. I was not expecting that. Oh, my goodness. Oh, man. Yeah, I've seen stuff like that before, too. Actually, this one time. When I was working security. I had this, it was like a place where people went to meet up with their, like, caseworkers, you know, if they had, like, a mental illness. So it was like a therapist's office, and the electricity was out because there was a fire in the electrical room, so it took out the whole building. And I had to work, like, different shifts, sometimes the swing shift, sometimes the overnight. Early morning. So I would end up having to be there when it was dark. Alright. So this particular occasion, it was actually daytime, like middle of the day. I think it was my second day at the site. And I was, checking, doing my rounds, making sure there was nobody, no actual people in the building, because there wasn't supposed to be. And I wasn't out of the corner of my eye. I was looking dead on at this, like, open theater area. And I saw it was a shadow. I say it's a shadow. But it was actually a solid being, and it's just all black, no facial expressions or nothing. It freaking leaned out of this dark doorway and looked dead at me. And I was like, nope. I turned around and I walked out the front door because I was like, I ain't having that. So I ended up staying outside for the rest of the day. Like, my shift was like from noon till 8 p.m. And I was not having none of that. I was like, nope. So anytime I went into the building, especially in that, like, back area, because I had to, it was part of my job. I had to go into that building to make sure that everything was good to go. They didn't have cameras or anything. So mainly what I would do is walk around the exterior just to make sure, like, because there was no other doors or windows that actually opened. Like, there's the emergency exits, like two of them, so I just go to make sure that those weren't tampered with and open. But for the most part, I would stay outside. But I don't know what they call, like, my lead. They would show up and be like, hey, are you walking the inside as well? And I'm like, yeah, I'm walking the inside. You know, I lied to him. He's like, all right, because you know, we can usually tell when you're not walking the inside. I'm like, oh, sure, how? Like, there's no freaking way a dude doesn't have... There's no security cameras because there's no electricity. Like, anywhere. There's not even backup electricity. Like, it's dead, dead. Like, dark, dark in there. So I was like, all right. I'll continue to do it. So I continue to not do it. And one day, a dude comes by and he's like, all right, man, you need to make sure that you're doing it. How the hell does he even know? Like, there's no way of him knowing. Uh-oh. I'm screwing this up. Oh, no, I'm not. But yeah, I was like, there's no way of him knowing this. But somehow he knew, so I had to be going up in there and making sure that I was checking everything. Everything was on the up and up. So I did. And anytime I had to go into that back room, it was that advanced darkness like I was talking about earlier, where it was definitely a like completely solid black mass inside of like a doorway. And oops, that's not what the fuck. So there was just like there was no light escaping the area. If that makes sense. And I had a flashlight, a big ass mag light, like the one that took like the 4D batteries. That was like my flashlight to see in the dark and my ass whooping weapon if I needed to. Which, thank goodness I didn't need to. And so this one was like kept that good. So. So yeah, I'm even shining my flashlight in there, and I should be able to see something in there. There was nothing. Like, there was no light going into there. No reflection on anything. And it was a kitchen that was in there. Well, you see what I'm talking about right here? See how there's this light right here? But there's no, you can't see, it's not reflecting off anything, it's just dark. So that's the type of shit I'm talking about that I saw. Oh wait, I didn't. Hold up. Who's on this? Oh, damn it. Okay, so that one's sideways. A certain way, that one's straight, and that one's sideways, so they're sideways looking in, okay. So is there anything else I'm supposed to be doing with this thing? Oh, the windows as well, huh? They're part of the puzzle. Okay, so I do have some other freaky, like many, many freaky stories, but I'll save them for when I start this back up, because it is already past the 2 hour mark and I don't want to keep y'all. Oh wait, those need to be open. This is closed. There it is. So does that mean she's got her baby now, or what? Oh, fuck. There's no way out of here. Door. Oh, okay, here we go. Okay. This is a baby tractor, baby. Oh, what the f- I guess I'm going upstairs into the nursery, probably? So what am I supposed to put that on then?
0-3-7-3-5.
Anyway. It's going to do it for this episode, though, y'all. I'm going to have to break this one up on YouTube into probably two parts. Because it's so long. But if you ever get a chance, you want to come back, you want to check out something, you know, revisit like a conversation, something that I said that you liked or didn't like. So you can tell your friends, like, hey, he's stupid or something. Check me out on YouTube. You can rewatch the videos because I upload them. I download them from Twitch and upload them on YouTube. So this one's definitely going to be a two-parter. I'm just going to break it up into like hour clips. But yeah, hit me up, SizzleChessIn on YouTube. You can find me at GrimTVR.com, which is my podcast, Grim Radio. We also have a YouTube channel, GrimTVR, on YouTube. And if you want to, you know, see some of the stupid stuff I'm into, you can find me on Facebook and Instagram at WaxLucero. I'm not on Twitter anymore. I really was a Twitter guy. So I just kind of stayed off that platform. I'm not really doing much on TikTok yet, but I will be, you know, doing some new videos pretty soon. I've just been so busy, but, you know, and I'm homesick right now. Hopefully we'll get better within the next 24 hours. thanks for stopping in. Hopefully you come check me out on everything else. You know, I'm always going to be here. I'm not going anywhere anytime soon. So later.